Hello everyone, I am Kana Shahid. Welcome back. This is our first fourth lecture in electronics measurement. And today the topic that we are discussing is about power measurement in audio and video frequency. And today's topic, the method that we have already discussed in our previous videos, previous lecture, is these three methods: theometer, colometer and calorimeter method. Today we are going to discuss about power measurement on transmission line, or you can say the special considerations that we are going to need to for power measurement on transmission line. So what is power measurement on transmission line is like that for a perfectly terminated transmission line, if we have the impedance, if we know that the impedance throughout the line is equal to the characteristic impedance, and we can definitely use this formula and measure the power across the transmission line. The formula is simple, that is I square R O is square by R. So if you know the characteristic impedance throughout the transmission line is R, and if we are able to measure the current flowing through the line and the voltage, then we can use this formula and find out the power. The accuracy can be the accuracy will be good if the load impedance of the transmission line is approximately equal to the characteristic impedance. And obviously the arrangement to measure the voltage or current across the transmission line, that should not introduce any irregularity, because it will imply the reflected wave. And the purpose here in transmission line is when we are measuring the power is to minimize the reflection. We need a minimum reflected wave in the measurement. So the transmission line current, so if we know the characteristic impedance of the coaxial cable, and the current can be measured at radio frequency, you can say at high frequency, the current can be measured in the transmission line using the thermocouple. A thermocouple can be used to provide the accuracy of current only if the the heater wire of the thermocouple has a very negligible amount of steam effect. And the voltage across the transmission line can also be determined by using the vacuum tube diode tube or vacuum tube voltmeter. But the condition is that the frequency should be low. Why? Because at lower frequency, the input capacitance of the voltmeter that will be centered across the transmission line must have a reactance that is very much higher than the characteristic impedance of the line. And we know if the frequency of measurement is low, then we can have a reactance, very high reactance of input capacitance. But at the radio frequency, the requirement is not satisfied, as at radio frequency the capacitance will become very small, the reactance will become very small. So then the voltmeter, in that case, at radio frequency, the voltmeter that we are going to measure will be reflecting a large amount of wave. So the thing that we have realized till now, that if the impedance, the load impedance of the transmission line is approximately equal to characteristic impedance, and if we are able to measure the current in the by using a thermocouple of having a negligible amount of steam effect, and then if we are using a voltmeter to measure a voltage across the transmission line, then we can obviously measure the power. But the only problem that is arising in this measurement technique is that the input capacitance reactance should be high, and that is not being realized at radio frequency. So we have to make some a special arrangement at radio frequency so that this capacitance of voltmeter, whatever voltmeter I can do for the diode type voltmeter you are using across the transmission line, the reactance of that capacitance should be very high. So to make this reactance high at radio frequency, we are going to make some special arrangement. So the arrangement will look like this. So at radio frequency, this is your transmission line, you can say, and so this in this special arrangement, you can see that a diode voltmeter has been used, and it has been shunted across the transmission line. But the arrangement is that it has been connected across a specially designed section of the transmission line. So this section, you can say, it is a enlarged portion. It is an enlarged portion of the transmission line where this section has a greater area than the remaining section of the transmission line, and the length of this section is normally designed as quarter wavelength of the maximum frequency for which the measurement is being done. So here the diode is shunted across a specially designed section of the line which has a greater spacing between the inner and the outer conductor than the rest of the line. So the length is quarter of wavelength, and this enlarged spacing actually increases the inductance per unit length reduces the capacitance per unit length. So this enlarged spacing is actually increasing the inductance per unit length and reducing the capacitance per unit length. Further, the dielectric, the absence of dielectric in the this particular area also further reduces the capacitance of this section. At the same time, the shunting capacitance that this is C, when due to the larger spacing, the inductance increasing, the inductance of this particular length has increased and the capacitance has decreased. At the same time, this shunted capacitance behaves like it is distributed across the line, and it added to the capacitance of this section. Yeah, so overall it will add to the capacitance of this section. So by proper design, by maintaining this design, we can make sure that the ratio of inductance to capacitance at this section, in last section, is equal to the ratio of inductance to capacitance at the remaining section of the transmission line. The ratio of inductance to the capacitance, if the this is same, then we can say that the special section, if the ratio is equivalent, then we can say this special section has the same characteristic impedance as the remaining section of the transmission line. So that will help in introducing negligible amount of reflection in the system. That was our purpose in the first place, to design this special section in the transmission line. So if this is the meter that we can use in a transmission line to measure the power at radio frequency, and this section. So proper design, if we can maintain this ratio of inductance, then we can make sure that the the special session has the same characteristics to impedance as the remainder of the system and accordingly introduce a negligible reflection. So all frequency which is less than the frequency for which this session has been designed for quarter of wavelength, the design the behavior is independent of frequency. So it is really important to have the section not greater than length of wind by 4, and the same time. So using this type of meter, we can actually employ vacuum type voltmeter, or we can say diode voltmeter, to any highest frequency at which this meter will operate satisfactorily. So the initial problem was that if we were connecting this diode voltmeter, then due to the sun input, if we were connecting a diode voltmeter in this section, then the impedance matching was not happening, and hence the power measurement was not accurate due to the greater amount of reflected power. So reflected wave. So in this case, a special section has been designed for measurement at higher frequency, so that the ratio, whatever the design we have made, only to make sure that the impedance, characteristic impedance, remain constant throughout the transmission line. In spite of adding the diode voltmeter, the characteristic impedance should not change. So this is the arrangement to make sure only that. After that, you know that how to measure the power measurement in transmission line. If you know, we know that this characteristic impedance, and we can properly measure the current, and using the voltmeter now we can accurately measure the voltage, and hence we can use the power measurement. So this is basically the theoretical concept to understand about how we are making some arrangement to make sure that we measure the power accurately in the transmission line at various frequency. For the different methods, we will discuss the different next method in our next lecture. So thank you for now, and for further details, you can go through this book by turning to it. Thank you so much.